It's a sore subject for Fondren residents in Jackson. After complaining for almost a week about low water pressure, it took their street swallowing a truck to get work crews to fix that problem.
Yeah, a waste management garbage truck turned at Seneca Avenue when the road gave way. 16 WAPT Scott Simmons found out who's accountable for the massive sinkhole. He joins us live now. Scott.
Yeah, storm drain pipe cracked, also a 6-inch water line. Residents in this Fondren neighborhood say they've been complaining about problems before this latest one popped up. Now they wonder if the repair job they're getting is really the fix they need.
A waste management garbage truck stopped in its tracks.
It took a dump truck to fall into a hole before they, you know, might actually do something, so.
The garbage truck was almost swallowed by the crater. Seneca Avenue residents were annoyed. They have been complaining since last week about low water pressure.
We basically run around the shower for about 20 minutes to try to get wet.
And now the work crews working on the gaping hole outside Catherine Burkhalter's home is small comfort.
What happens is they'll patch one area and then, you know, 3 weeks later, another area about 20 feet down.
Residents say they're used to seeing repair crews out here. In fact, about 6 weeks ago, crews were out here working on a leak at this one spot. Residents say that's part of the problem. City crews come out to patch the problem, but they don't actually fix it.
I've lived here for 5 years. This is the fourth time that street's been dug up all the way across.
Jacqueline Day says she is sick of seeing it.
If you go down this street and you count, it looks like a patchwork quilt.
The crater that claimed the garbage truck has opened a sore subject with residents on Seneca who say they need long-term repairs, not patchwork fixes.
Right, it's just a costly measure. We do have some older water lines in certain parts of the city that give us a lot of problems, but we are working through that.
Jackson spokesman Chris Mims says the city is fixing the damage on Seneca, but the older pipes here are a lot like what is throughout the city of Jackson.
And so you have 900 miles of water pipes that you have to deal with. So we have waterline breaks, we have leaks that we have to prioritize, and so we try to get to everyone as quickly as we can, but we have to oftentimes we have to handle the emergency situations first.
But this is a priority for Fondren residents who admit after this crater is fixed, they'll wonder when the next one will pop up.
Mim says the city has spent about $80 million in water system improvements, but residents on Seneca contend that it makes more sense to replace the problem they often face rather than have a long list of patchwork problems. Live in the newsroom, Scott Simmons, 16 WAPT News.
Okay, Scott, thank you so much.